This is Roger with Wheel Connects in Tucson, Arizona. We're selling this Excursion. It is a 2004 Ford Excursion Limited. It's four-wheel drive, 6.0 turbo diesel. It has 212,000 miles. It was a dealer trade-in to the Larry Miller new car group. They can't sell anything on their used car dealership with over 100,000 miles, which clearly this is. They can't get financing for their used car people through their lenders. So they sell them to independents, and we pick off all the diesels that are nice, and this is one of them. This is a really nice rig. When we got it here, we did our usual two-hour inspection, which looks like this. Then I got my little cheat sheets over here. That's the stuff that we did to it. It got a new ICP, new IPR. It got a new hub lock. We did a Rotella oil and filter. So it's got new oil and a oil filter, one glow plug, the steering stabilizer is new, two injectors on number 3 and 5 were just a little bit low, and it got a new EGR valve, not an EGR cooler, a new EGR valve, okay? And that's it. Then it went to detail, and this is it. Nice rig. I'm going to walk around, I'm going to show you what it's got. These are the tires that came on it, so someone liked it recently enough. Liked it enough to recently put some new tires on it. I mean, those are some very high rubber tires. Or they thought they'd get more in trade for it. It's just, that's a very dumb thing to do, by the way, when you're trading in a vehicle. Don't go buy tires for it. It's got, you know, rock chips on the bumper. Tuba touch-up paint would be nice, because I know that there's a scratch, I think, under the driver cargo window that would like a little bit of touch-up paint, but leaving it this way kind of gives people a better idea of what they're buying and what it was. I mean, this is a very well-maintained vehicle, obviously. Cosmetically, it's really pretty. We scanned it, and those codes came up for the things that we did, but it ran fine, but we can't have those codes in there, and when they have the codes, we gotta change the parts whether it's showing any symptoms or not. So we do. Got a nice tow hitch. So, I like these barn doors, those are cool. They open like that. There's a lot of cargo area behind the third seat. Here's your third seat. Obviously, you got a spare right here inside, which is nice. You don't have to. Yikes. I'll have to grab that. Here's your roof. There's the scratch I'm talking about. Right here and here, a little bit here. Those things would go almost completely away. It'd be about 95% better with about 1 minute of touch-up paint work and a $10 touch-up paint. Here are your keys with a remote. Like that. Fired up, we're gonna look under the hood. We had it running for about an hour before I came out here. I just turned it off maybe, I don't know, 15, 20 minutes ago. 212,009 miles. Go under the hood. I already unscrewed the oil cap so I don't burn my fingers on the oil cap like I did the other day. No blow-by at all. Whew. No blow-by at all. There's your Ford stamp there. There's your Ford stamp there. The Ford stamps indicate that nothing's been changed. The only reason to change these things in the Ford stamp there is if you have a wreck or some sort of collision damage. So all this front end stuff is original. When they crash them and they replace them, they don't put the original parts back on. They're too expensive. Oh, and I locked the doors. Perfect. So, this is the driver rear door. Window up and down. Seats look really good for the miles and the year. Look excellent. We got some controls here to put headphones in. Let's see. You got rear control air here. So, do that. Then you go like that. Take the headrest out. You put the headrest into these things. And then it'll lay completely flat. That's how that works. There's your passenger rear window. So you have the driver rear window on that side, passenger rear window on this side. Nice car, really nice car. Same thing with this one. You just pull this up. You would take this headrest out and put it in these holes, and then like that. Obviously, with that out there, it just lays down flat. Pretty simple. Here's your passenger front window, door locks, seat back, go forward, and back, up, that was already up already, let's go up, down, and then up, there you go. Let's see, tilt the front, the rear seat at back, and down, up, down, you got the, on and off. You do have a manual and some sort of trailer pigtail that they never used. It's a nice view. Really nice. There's your driver window, passenger window, passenger rear window. Driver rear window, mirrors, out, in, down, up, other side, out, in, up, down. Let's see what else we got here. Seat, driver seat back, forward, up, down, tilt up, tilt down, rear tilt down. Rear tilt up. I can see our mobile repair guy came. There's probably a tear right here that he fixed. And right here he fixed. Let's see, what else we got? We got tilted wheel. That works fine. We got air conditioning that thank God is working because it's freaking hot and humid. Monsoon season here in Tucson. The vents off of the speaker here. Cooker. It's about 101 and about 50% humidity. It'll rain this afternoon for sure. All right, let's see. Radio. There's volume from the steering wheel. Change the station from the steering wheel. Let's see. Radio works fine. Let's see. There's AC. Let's try these. There's the steering wheel AC controls. Up, let's go with temperature up, temperature down. There you go. Power pedals. It's a brake pedal. It's power on this thing, up and down. There you go. Let's see what else we got. There's the rear air. I can hear that running. That's fine. There's the rear vent windows in the cargo area. See that out and in. Other side. There you go. Okay. Now, there's overdrive. If you can see that, I'm doing that with this. There's the tow haul on and off. I don't know if you can see that or not. No. On and off, off. There you go. All right, we put it into neutral. We put it into four low. Now we're in four low. Drive. That's in four low. And reverse. Four low, perfect. Neutral, let's go to two. That's four high. Now we're in four high and drive. And reverse. All right, and back to neutral and back to two-wheel drive. Now I want to check the parking sensors. There you go. Everything is working. All right, this thing is on a clear title. It is a dealer trade-in. Told you why and how we got it. Told you what we've done, what we scanned, what we fixed, etc. If you come to Tucson and drive it home, you're going to pay tax and dock fees. Dock fees $250. Tax is 2% city sales tax plus whatever your state tax rate is. So if your state tax rate is, say, 3%, you come here, you're going to pay 5% tax, your 3 plus our 2, and a $250 dock fee. If you pay by wire and ship, all you're going to pay is the agreed upon price, and that's it. Once it ships to your door, you will take it to Motor Vehicles and pay them whatever tax or fees they require to get plates on it. Once we receive full payment by wire, we will fill in the title the way you want it with your name and address, your company's name and address, and we will mail it off to you. It'll be notarized, everything. It'll be scanned into your online file, so you'll be able to see it even before it hits the mail. We even scan in the envelope that we mail it in, okay? Let's see. Deposit. Please get your deposit in. Once we have your deposit, which is $500, we will put a banner over the excursion at wheelconnects.com. You'll know it's yours. Until then, it's for sale. These diesel excursions are gone. They don't make them anymore, so these things go pretty quickly. They used to sit around 4 or 5 years ago, but now they are fairly quick. So get your deposit in so you're not disappointed. You know, we come to an agreement on a price at 8 in the morning. Don't wait till you're home to do the deposit, you know, at 5 o'clock, because by then it could be gone. Warranty information. Obviously, it's very out of warranty by years and miles. If Ford could have given it a 25-year, 300,000-mile warranty, they would have. What they're saying with the warranty they gave it is they don't know what's going to happen to it after X amount of years or X amount of miles. Makes sense, right? If they don't know what's going to happen to it, there's very little chance that we know more than the people who built it. We are experts on 6.0s, no doubt about it, but we don't know more than the people who built it, okay? So there is risk involved in buying this vehicle, just like there's risk in buying anything used, whether it's a toaster or a Lazy Boy recliner or anything, really. So please make sure that you're able to accept some risk. We tell you as much as we possibly can tell you about this vehicle, using a lot of knowledge of ours, past experiences, scans, inspections, etc. You know everything we know. You know more than anybody could possibly know about a used vehicle. But there's still risk. So it could get to you, and you know, the day you get it, it could need an injector, or it could need a windshield wiper motor, or a radio knob or something. Who knows? All right? If you don't like risk, don't buy this vehicle. They don't make too many diesel SUVs anymore, especially this size. So I'm not sure what I would tell you to do as an alternative. But I will tell you that if you don't like risk, don't buy anything used, and don't buy from us, because there's risk involved and we're not paying for repairs. So that being said, hell of a car. If you are concerned about the one bugaboo, which is the EGR, we do an EGR cooler from Bulletproof and a Ford oil cooler with new fluids and everything for $1,900, only for people who buy from us. If you're if you want it done on your 6.0, we charge, depends on how much work it is, but at least $2,900. So if you want this Bulletproof before it leaves, add $1,900 bucks. Thank you.